There's a weasel in that grass there. Oh yeah, there's a weasel. How you doing, Diesel? Top of the morning to you. It's kind of a miserable morning, but top of the miserable morning to you. It's cold, it's wet. Must be in Canada. But just because Mother Nature's having a bad hair day doesn't mean I have to have a bad day. I'm having actually a pretty good morning. I'm feeling good. We're gonna get as far as we can today. It's gonna be a good day. It's kind of nice not being in the searing heat anymore. It's kind of nice sort of just having a cool day. I just hope this doesn't turn to snow and ice. I don't think it will. I can see my breath though. You see that? Yeah. That's a good sign. Must mean I'm like home. So, it's gonna be a little bit of a cooler day, like I was saying. Diesel, you okay with that?
No, I'm okay with that, man. It's cool. I got fur.
Good for you, I don't. So yes, we're in Ignace, Ontario. There it is. We moved over here closer to the bush, so we wouldn't have to walk through all the mud to get Diesel to the bush, but. Anyways, we're gonna hit the road now. Just a cold, wet day today. We left Ignace a little while ago. We're headed east. It's kind of nice because driving into the afternoon, you don't have the sun in your face when you're driving east, right? Because it's setting behind you. And I'm the kind of guy I'd rather drive late than stop early, right? Because I get into that habit in the summertime because I can't fall asleep when it's so hot, right? So I would prefer to sleep later and drive later if time permits and if the load allows for it. That way I can fall asleep when it's nice and cool at night, and then the heat in the morning wakes me up. For some reason I can't sleep when it's hot, so when it gets hot in the morning, I'm up. Alright, we're gonna stop at the mighty, mighty Flying J, just east of Thunder Bay. Apparently, it's mostly under construction. They only got two pumps open. Nice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 pumps, but... Oh, you can only use 2 of them. And we're gonna leave a little cliff there for you to drop off of. Nice. Very nice. What are they doing here? I don't understand. Anyways, we're gonna get our go-go juice. And then we're gonna head, 1 second here. Then we're gonna head a little bit down the road to Nipigon where they have a Timmy's, and I'm gonna get my own go-go juice. And then we'll be ready to go. Does that make sense? I think that makes sense. What's the price of fuel here? $1.349 per liter. I'll figure it out for my American friends. Don't worry, I'm giving you an American price right away. Just hold on. $1.39. If you ever want to do this yourself, you know, it's pretty easy. You go $1.399 per liter, right? No, not $1.349. $1.349 per liter times 3.78. $5.09. So $5.10 per US gallon is what I'm paying for fuel here right now. That's why when I was down south, I was like thinking $3.80 a gallon? That is cheap. I'm paying $5.10 a gallon for the same fuel here. Funny thing is, we got more oil up here. You'd think it'd be cheaper where most of the oil is, but no. It's cheaper where the most volume is sold, that's why. Down there they sell a lot more, I'm guessing. I think the real reason besides that is taxes. Up here we have a lot more taxes, which boosts the price of everything. Lots and lots of taxes. But we do have free healthcare, you know? If I fall out of my truck right now, break my collarbone, I just go to the nearest hospital and get it all fixed up for free and I'm on my way.
Absolutely. No questions asked. All I gotta do is show my health card to show proof that I'm a Canadian citizen and that I'm covered under their healthcare system, which every Canadian citizen is. That's the only thing we really have to say. Or the only real thing that we have to show for our incredibly high taxes. Other than that, I can't complain about our taxes because we live in a free country. And it is not free to live in a free country. Does that make sense? Freedom isn't free. Popular phrase down south in the States and a popular phrase up here in Canada within our militaries. Freedom isn't free. It also applies to civilian life, like what I'm talking about right now, how gas prices are more expensive and diesel prices and everything's more expensive. But we have the freedom to do anything we want in this country. We have the freedom to be anything we want within, you know, as long as we're not hurting anyone else. Like, you're not allowed to be a terrorist. You're not free to be a terrorist in our country. Sorry, our freedoms don't go that far. But you're free to live whatever lifestyle you want, marry whoever you want, as long as they are a human being. You are free to work wherever you want, live wherever you want, speak whatever languages you want, though our main languages are English and French. That's what you got to do business in. But you're free to live whatever culture you want. Hey, if I wanted to be a Buddhist tomorrow, hey, A-okay with the Canadian government. Whatever. Who cares? As long as I'm not bringing harm to anyone else. Freedom. I've been talking long about this. That'll probably be the name of today's vlog. Freedom. Right, Diesel? We are blessed to live in a free nation. Free from oppression. I can be whoever I want to be, and I have the right to be whoever I want to be without persecution or discrimination. So I decided to be a YouTuber.
Quite the operation they got going on over here at the Flying J Thunder Bay. Very interesting. I see a Porsche on that car. I spy with my little eye a Porsche. Nice. Very nice.
Oh, that fender looks so nice. I really like these headlights. These headlights are much better. It's dual bulb. Way brighter than the old lights. Really happy that they decided to do that when they fixed my truck. And they replaced this side too so that they match. But this one's a used one. I can tell because this one's new. It's shinier. And that one's not new. And I haven't put any plate in my grill again like I usually have. I usually have a plate there, a polar bear plate, or a Trucker Josh plate. But I decided to wait till I get my moose bumper. And then I believe the moose bumper comes with two or three spots, four plates. So I can have my regular license plate in the correct spot. And then on the other side, I can have my polar bear plate or my Trucker Josh plate or whatever. But my polar bear plate actually comes from Yellowknife. Yellowknife is the capital of Northwest Territories. Uh-oh. I guess the fuel is done. Let's go check it out. Oh, it's windy here. Of course it's windy. I started vlogging. So I'm just curious here. I figured something out here. At these pumps, the Flying J in Thunder Bay, they have this down here. Alternate selection buttons for screen prompts above. So these buttons here, are the same as these here. So like if I press, see this one's for French, I would press this one, it would all turn to French, right? So then you go down to this bottom one, you press that, and it turns to French. See that? That's not the point. The point is that it says that these are for wheelchair people, which makes sense, right? It makes sense that you would want lower buttons for people who are in wheelchairs so they can reach it more. Or reach it better. It's more accessible to people in wheelchairs. Thinking, that's good. Now what I'm wondering is, do they make semi-trucks that are wheelchair accessible? This is a serious question, I'm actually honest. Because I've never seen a semi-truck with like a ramp, but I bet you that'd be awesome though. You know, like the door just pops open, it's like, lowers the wheelchair onto the ground. Just curious. They make pumps here and buttons here for people in wheelchairs. But I've never seen a person in a semi-truck get out of a semi-truck and get into a wheelchair. Like, don't take that the wrong way. I'm not discriminating. I'm not making fun or anything. I'm honestly curious. Are there people who live their lives in wheelchairs because of maybe a military accident or maybe just a car accident? You know, there's a lot of people out there who have to be in wheelchairs every day. And it'd be awesome if they could drive trucks too. Absolutely. Why should they have to? Like, driving truck, you don't need your legs necessarily. I've seen trucks that have hand controls. I mean, vehicles, but not semi-trucks. Just curious. Why would they put that on the pump there? It obviously means that it happens, right? Let me know, you guys. Let me know if disabled wheelchair people or people who use a wheelchair on a regular basis, if they drive trucks.
Alright, so we are on Highway 102. This is the bypass, sort of a shortcut to get through Thunder Bay, Ontario. Some nice scenery here. Every day there's less and less leaves on the trees, on the coniferous trees. The evergreens are still green, as they are evergreen, always evergreen. Area here. I figured I'd give you a little speedy tour through here. I like to do that at least once or twice a day. So why not right here?
Look at that view. We're at a rest area here in Marathon, Ontario.
As if you're, you know, running a marathon. Marathon, Ontario.
And that's the view up there. Can you see it?
So we're going to go and take a look. See what they got in this building here. I think it's closed, but I'm gonna go take a look at what this is here anyways. Since we're here, why not? So it's actually a ski hill.
So you ski down here, I guess. Where's my hand? There it is. And you come up these cables up to here in the winter time.
That's awesome. In the winter time, I can just pull over and park over here and go for a rip. Bring my toboggan. Oh, that'd be fun, just ripping down there on a toboggan. You can get a ride back up with the lift.
Interesting.
That's what it looks like on this side.
Cool.
That is some hardcore equipment.
They don't want us to go on there though. It's the off season, that's why nobody's here. I thought it was a rest area. Nuh-uh, it's a ski hill with parking. So it's sort of like a rest area. It's a little bit windy here, sorry.
Just in case you want to anchor up your boat.
There you go. I don't know how you get your boat up here, but there's another one here.
Those big chains are for? I'm sure they serve a purpose of some sort. Probably for the ski lift thing. Anyways, this is the little ski resort here.
Speaking of tying up boats, got a big blue anchor. How about that? What is this place?
Creating jobs, building Ontario.
Investing in water infrastructure. Action plan.
Interesting.
Anybody home? It's locked.
Please help keep our services free. Please come in and sign our guest book.
I'd love to sign your guest book, but your doors are locked.
Pets are prohibited from all town marathon facilities.
You're racist.
Service animals.
Diesel's a service animal. He's my navigator.
What's this?
Don't feed the bears, stash your trash.
Watch, I'll open this, there'll be a bear in there.
Cool.
Pepsi, where's the Coke machine?
Apparently they don't like Coke here either.
So yeah, this is, I guess... Oh, cool, we can go over here too?
Nothing saying I can't, so here we go.
Look, you got these big chains everywhere. There's another chain there. Another chain here. Hey, is this door unlocked?
Oh, that door's locked too. I have a feeling I'm not supposed to be inside there.
So we found ourselves some kind of patio here. How about that, eh? These are some huge trees. This is like one solid tree at one point. Wherever it came from. And I guess you can ski right down there, or toboggan, or whatever, and then take the lift all the way back up to there. Cool. Very nice. Very nice indeed. I still wonder what all these big chains are for. They're huge.
To a sailor, that's probably a little chain, but
to a truck driver,
you're a pretty heavy-duty chain.
I feel like I'm in some kind of tribal council area here. All you need is like torches on these things. I'll feel like I'm in Survivor or something. Tribal council. Cool. I've never actually been here before. Very interesting. Reminds me of home a lot, except they got more hills here. Interesting. Yeah, this is the place. If you're ever passing through Marathon, and you got yourself a toboggan, a truck parking here, you can just stop on by and take a rip down the hill over there. Why not? Why not?
Marathon, if you hadn't figured out how to spell it yet. That's the town we're at. Marathon.
Might be stopping there tonight. I won't be quite out of hours, but I don't know if I'll have enough hours to get down to Sault Ste. Marie, which is the next major stop for trucks, which is probably a few to several hours down the road yet after that. So we'll check it out once we get there. We shall see. This was the most secluded part of Ontario that we're getting through. We're going through right now. We're almost back to civilization. A couple more hours.
Paul, do you have a good day, Diesel? No tail wag? Good boy.
Yeah, we had a good day. It started off kind of with the cold weather and the rain and whatnot, but it turned out to be really good. I told you it would. It always does. So, we're in Wawa. Wawa, Ontario. W-A-W-A, just like we thought we would be. That's where we'll be spending the night. I'm running a little low on hours. I don't have quite enough to continue through. The next stretch of highway is, what is it called? Like Lake Superior National Park or something like that, or Provincial Park. And there's no stops in there until you get through to Sault Ste. Marie. So we'll be staying here tonight and continuing on tomorrow. Tomorrow we should get to destination. If we don't make it there before they close, we'll unload first thing the next day in the morning. But I'm hoping to get there tomorrow before they close. We'll see. I can't go any further in there anyways. I got to sleep there. That'll be the end of my day. And then we're going to Pointe à la Crosse, Quebec. That'll take almost a full day to get there. And then from there, we're going to the ferry in North Sydney, Nova Scotia. That'll take us to Newfoundland. That's the story of my life the next couple of days, guys. Thanks for joining me on the story of my life today. I'll see you again tomorrow at 4 a.m. Central Time to see what we're doing then.
Say goodbye, Diesel. Say goodbye, Diesel. And give a little tail wag, man. Oh, come on, don't be rude. You a good boy? See you guys tomorrow.